part of quantitative reasoning is doing the math correctly and understanding where your numbers come from and how to calculate them. But the reasoning portion is the next step, is understanding how to use those numbers to tell a story.
It's not just about learning tools, but it really is about teaching students how to think in a precise manner, in a rigorous manner.
The quantitative reasoning flag, or at least the concepts that we're trying to get across with the flag, should be applicable to many events in your normal course of living.
We're going to be able to show you some direct examples of how to use quantitative reasoning techniques such as analysis, simulation, modeling, probability, and statistics.
The first part of the course, we learn all the tools that we needed, and then in the second part of the course, we just learn applications to the most interesting problems you could possibly think of. And it was the sort of thing that, like, every week your mind would be blown by, like, how you could apply those, like, really simple mathematical tools to these real-life problems.
In the general chemistry course, 302, we have a couple things in mind we try to do. One, kind of like to have them look around and see what the world's like and see if they can't apply many of the things we talk about to things they see on an everyday basis. The next step is to see if they can't quantitatively develop a relationship between what we've taught them in class and ultimately what they see. For example, last summer we had a major fish kill because of the depletion in oxygen in Lake Travis. We try to relate that to them and again try to put it on a quantitative basis.
With quantitative reasoning, and especially with Holcomb, he teaches you how to think. So he teaches you, think, this is logical. It's logical that this solution is getting more acidic.
The professor introduced us for the first time to the logics behind the Google PageRank algorithm, and it was fantastic to see something that is in everyone's life just explained to you right there.
We have so many different messages in the media, and so many different messages are being presented that students need to be critical thinkers and be adept at being able to understand those numbers and the assumptions behind them. And I think once students get that, a lot of students have told me, oh, this was the first class where it actually made sense to me because we did something with the numbers.
Part of the goal of a university education is to become informed as a citizen, and we all need to be able to use quantitative reasoning to understand what's happening to us every day and to be able to make informed decisions.
Since I'm not a science major, quantitative reasoning and just dealing with numbers and reasoning from them, it helps me connect the fact that these equations and everything that you're using aren't just random equations that you have no access to.
I've had engineers and computer scientists and economics majors and business majors, finance majors. The tools that they learn in this class are relevant to each of their fields. Probably one of the main things that you get out of a course where you have a lot of quantitative reasoning, a lot of mathematics, is really to learn how to become persistent and to really question your way through a problem, to really look at each step along the way and say, am I still on track?